Hey everyone, I've spoken about 12-volt power a lot in my previous videos because it melts, which completely sucks. But CES 2026 has just wrapped up and some companies have brought out brand new products which they claim will fix 12-volt power once and for all. Can that be believed? Well, that's what I'm going to talk about in this video. And firstly, I wanted to talk about Seasonic because I was really expecting them to have unveiled some new PSUs, but unfortunately that didn't happen. They've been delayed quite a lot. So Seasonic last year, around May, they announced some next generation PRIME PSUs that had extra sensors that were apparently going to fix everything, and this was unveiled in Computex 2025. And they actually had a prototype as well where they were showing that basically these new Prime PSUs would have two-factor protection. It's actually a little bit like the CoolerMaster solution, which I'll talk about later on in this video. But Seasonic's one was all about actually having an external device that would beep and make noises and alert people if there was a problem with their graphics card with the 12-volt power connector. But obviously if somebody wasn't right at their computer and they couldn't hear the beep, there'd be extra circuitry within the actual PSU as well that could potentially turn off the PSU and the computer if, you know, there was a current imbalance on the 12-volt power cables. So this solution sounded really, really good, and originally Seasonic were telling people, including Tom's Hardware, that these new Prime PSUs would be finished by the end of the year, meaning 2025, and then they would be sold in the first quarter of 2026, meaning now. But then something interesting happened, which was that Seasonic didn't really mention anything about these new PSUs in CES 2026, which I thought was a bit odd. So I actually reached out to Seasonic and I spoke to them and asked what was going on. And what they told me was that they're still actively working on OptiGuard, which was introduced during Computex, and they can't currently share an exact release date, but basically said that selected Prime Series products will be equipped with this feature later this year. But that's actually a bit of a pity for me because I actually really wanted to buy these new Seasonic PSUs, and yeah, originally they were going to be released and then it seemed to get delayed. So I went back to them and just said, has it been delayed? And what they told me was that product roadmaps can change and expectations are not always met as originally planned. And that's actually kind of interesting wording. And, you know, I didn't speak to like the CEO, so it might just be that somebody misspoke slightly, but I find it a bit interesting when they say that, yeah, the expectations aren't always met. Like, was it that there were some corner cases where, you know, they're working on this fancy new technology, but in maybe 1 out of 10 situations, maybe it wasn't turning off the PSU if there was a current imbalance in the actual cable? We can't completely know, but obviously, yeah, originally Seasonic were going to release their 12-volt protection OptiGuard right now, and now it's been delayed and it's just going to be coming out later this year. So unfortunately, I know this video is about CES 2026 and obviously Seasonic aren't actually releasing this anymore, but I just wanted to cover this because actually, yeah, originally they were going to unveil and actually sell these PSUs right now, and that's not actually happening. But thankfully we do have a few alternatives, firstly from MSI, which is this one, and then also from CoolerMaster. And I'm going to start out talking about the MSI one because this looks pretty cool. And we know that MSI have had some issues along the way. Certainly a lot of the melting story out there seem to have been with this MSI yellow tipped adapter. Obviously not every case of melting is with the yellow tipped adapter, and I'm not saying there's anything specifically wrong with the MSI one, but it's just interesting that, you know, MSI heralded this sort of yellow tipped connector so that, you know, if you weren't plugging in the connector all the way, you'd see a little bit of yellow and then you'd know, oh, I haven't plugged in enough, and you'd push in the connector, you know, all the way. But anywho, MSI have now brought out this new PSU which has GPU Safeguard Plus. So they've got a press release which we'll look at in a minute, but actually the video card's website is probably clearer than the press release is, so I'm going to start off focusing on that. What MSI have shown is there's multiple phases. So the first is actually detecting that something has gone wrong. And basically the way that the anomaly detection is going to work is that if you look at a 12-volt power connector, you've basically got 12 pins. 6 are for the grounds and then 6 are the actual lives. So basically you've got 6 wires here where the current is actually flowing down. And what MSI's solution will be doing is actually looking at each individual wire, all the 6 of them anyway, it's ignoring the grounds, it's only looking at the actual, you know, current ones. But basically, if there's an imbalance in the amount of current that's flowing down each wire, then an anomaly will be detected. And that is actually incredibly important because, as DeBauer and other people have shown, what can actually happen is, let's say you've got a slightly loose connection in 2 of your wires and you've got an RTX 5090 drawing 600 watts of power. If 2 of those wires are faulty or not really working adequately, then what's going to happen is the remaining 600 watts are going to flow down the remaining 4 wires. And that can be a really bad thing then for melting. And that's why sometimes when you see melting happening, it can happen on certain pins, because effectively it might be that most of the current has been going down and hitting this particular pin. So basically MSI's solution is going to be actually detecting whether there's an anomaly in actually the current supply, and then there's going to be a warning. So you're firstly going to get a really annoying beeping for 3 minutes. And when I say annoying, I actually mean that as a good thing, not a bad thing. But you're going to get that actually beeping from the PSU or a little speaker that's mounted to that. But also if you've got MSI software as well in the MSI center, that's going to show a pop-up on your system as well, and it's also going to show a little status icon showing that something is wrong. So you can see the image there. Instead of saying normal, it's actually going to show that something is wrong. You're going to get an alert, and then, you know, ideally you should actually shut down your game or shut down your computer, and then you should actually unplug the connector and inspect it for any visual damage. But let's say you just ignore that, or you just don't hear it because you're away. Well, after 3 minutes, what's going to happen is the MSI system will actually force a black screen, which seems like a bit of a weird thing, like why wouldn't you just shut down? But essentially the idea is, if you're playing a game or running Thermark or AI software and it's drawing like 600 watts or whatever, by actually having that black screen, it's basically like turning off the game or whatever, that GPU is no longer going to use like 600 watts. It's going to actually, you know, mean that less current is flowing down each individual wire, and that can actually, in theory, safeguard the actual 12 volt power connector, but then the beeping will still continue. It says right there, buzzer still beeping, so it's going to keep beeping at you, and then eventually you're going to get back to your computer, you're going to hear that, and you also see the status in the actual, you know, in the control software, and then you're going to shut down your computer and actually look at things more. However, there is actually a bit of a catch here, because if we look at this comparison from MSI, they're bringing out two new sets of PSUs, one called MAG and one called MPG, and basically the MAG one is only GPU safeguard and not GPU safeguard plus. So what that means is you're still going to get the buzzer and you're going to get the current protection for actually monitoring the pins, but only to a certain extent, because you're not going to be able to use the MSI center, you know, the actual thing I shown earlier, you're not going to be able to use that on the MAG ones, only the MPG ones, and that's why this screenshot's probably just showing the MPG ones. And that also means you're not going to be able to monitor the current flowing down each individual pin. So basically you can see here, you can see your consumption, you can see exactly what the power draw is for every single connector and things like that, or every single pin that's carrying current on the 12 volt power connector. You're not going to actually get that if you've got the MAG PSUs, you're only getting the MPG ones. But certainly in terms of protecting your, you know, graphics card from melting, you, whether you go with the MAG or the MPG one, this solution in theory will actually do that. So that is the solution from MSI, and personally I'd probably buy like the MPG one and not the MAG one, because I'd want to be able to see, you know, all of the different per pin voltages or amperages in the actual software. So I'd probably go for the MPG one over the MAG one, but if you did only go for the MSI MAG one, you know, it is still going to protect you. And really the MSI press release says exactly the same thing, but actually shows slightly less detail than the video cards one, which is why I focused on that one. So it's talking about the protection and, you know, also how you can use MSI Center with MPG. Unfortunately, there's no sign yet of when these new PSUs are coming out. They've announced them, they said that they will be coming out, but we don't know an exact time. But if I've got more details, I'll put it in the description and in the comments and everything else. But that is the MSI solution. Next we come to CoolerMaster. And looking at what CoolerMaster have done, it's nothing completely groundbreaking. They've basically got a new PSU with some protection built in. And actually I've got some concerns about that, which I'll talk about in a minute. But the main thing that actually interests me is this adapter cable, which is a little bit like, you know, the Thermal Grizzly Wire View Pro. It's not as good as that, it's not got as many features. But basically what CoolerMaster have introduced is this new plug and play adapter. And actually what's interesting about this is you don't need to change your PSU or your GPU. So you can just have this, and effectively what you're going to do is plug your existing 12 volt power cable into here, and then this other end goes into your graphics card. But what that allows you to do is this magic box from CoolerMaster, which they call in the GPU shield adapter cable, that's actually going to again be looking at the current through all of the six pins, and if there's a problem it will then actively intervene. And unfortunately this is still fairly light on detail. We don't exactly know what actively intervenes means. You know, it might actually be doing what MSI are doing with actually, you know, turning off the display in certain cases, or maybe it's just going to shut down the system completely. We don't actually know that. But that is the GPU shield adapter cable from CoolerMaster. We don't know the price or the release date yet, which is a little bit annoying, but actually this could be a pretty good product. And based on the actual design of it as well, you know, the cable looks pretty good and it's fairly flexible. What it could mean is that this is more suitable for like Founders Editions GPUs, which has sometimes been a bit of a flaw with like the WireView Pro one, where, you know, depending on if the GPU has a right angled connector and things like that, sometimes the WireView solutions might not be suitable for that, although I think they are working on solutions for it. But the actual CoolerMaster one that we can see here does look a lot better. But the other thing then they've announced is their new modular PSU, the MWE Gold 4, and that then actually has some protection built in, and it's kind of not as good really as some of the other things. But what you can actually see if you look at the detail is it's got a GPU shield intelligent current management, and basically it's going to again detect abnormal currents, and then it will alert users through LED indicators. We can actually see a picture of that there. So you're either going to have a green light or red light. which feels a bit like Squid Game, really. But what's actually interesting with this particular, you know, PSU technology is there's no actually mention of it turning off the system if there's a current imbalance or anything like that. So, you know, maybe the details are light and maybe there'll be more details coming out in the future, in which case, again, I'll put more details in the description and in a pinned comment. But right now, from, you know, the pictures I've seen and the news articles I've read, I can't actually see how this PSU would be all that effective, because some cases actually hide the PSU in the back, including in this case, you know, you can't see the PSU, and as a result, you wouldn't be able to actually see the power LEDs. So I'm a little bit confused about this particular solution, or at least the power supply unit one, but the GPU shield adapter cable could actually be brilliant. That's actually quite interesting to me, for example, because in this particular computer, I've got a SAMA PSU and then a gigabyte, you know, GPU. And with a lot of these other solutions we're looking at, I'd have to change my power supply unit. You know, I'd have to buy a new Seasonic one or a new MSI one. But actually, if I could just buy this adapter cable, that could be a lot better for me. My main concern, though, with a solution like this from CoolerMaster is that actually, you know, take my system, I've got a SAMA PSU, gigabyte GPU, and then I would have a CoolerMaster GPU shield adapter cable. And you'd like to think that that would work and I'd not have any melting issues or anything like that. But if something did melt, who would I actually claim off? Would I claim off SAMA for the PSU? Would I claim off Gigabyte? Or would I claim off CoolerMaster? And if I did claim off all three, would they just blame each other? And then, you know, I don't get anywhere with my warranty claim and I'm just left with like a melted graphics card. That obviously would be the worst case scenario. And that kind of wraps things up. So essentially right now you've got an ASRock PSU with some protection built in and the YOVU Pro. They were both released last year. And now we've got this new one from MSI and CoolerMaster. And the CoolerMaster one is actually two solutions. Now we don't know the exact release dates or anything else, but hopefully we'll find that out soon, and maybe we'll actually finally get Seasonic's PSU at some point in 2026. So that wraps things up. If you've got any further questions, please leave them down in the comments. And if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.